Hello, and welcome back to Mark's Garden UK at Rose Cottage near Nantwich in Cheshire. And in this video, I'm going to share with you 12 innovative ideas on how to save and preserve water in the garden. We've had a very dry first half to the year, and recently we had two of the hottest days on record, and there's a mini heatwave forecast, so I have no doubt that there will be a hosepipe ban just around the corner. So this morning, I sat down with a piece of paper and scribbled down all the ideas I could come up with to save and preserve water in the garden. And I'm going to share that with you today. Now, I'm going to whistle through this at pace, but don't worry. I will write all these ideas in the description box below this video. I hope that you find it useful and informative and entertaining and that you like it. And if you do like it, please do hit the like button because that helps YouTube to understand it's a video of value. And so the first one of my ideas is to place all my terracotta pots inside plastic pots. Terracotta is known for being porous. It evaporates water, it leaches water out from the side. If you place that pot inside a plastic pot, it will create a little humid microenvironment around the terracotta and stop the water from evaporating. If you can then place that on a border, even better, because then any water which leaks through drains into the bed below. Furthermore, place that pot out of direct sunlight and in the shade of the gentle drying breeze, and we'll have a win-win-win. Choose the right time of day to water your plants, either early in the morning or late at night when the earth is cool. If you put water onto hot earth, the heat energy in the soil will just evaporate the water and it will do no good for the plants whatsoever. And the water droplets on the leaves may cause damage or scorching. So water early or water late for best results. Create little channels or gullies or indentations around the base of each plant to help the water to soak in rather than running off away from the base of the plant. And if the plant is on a slight slope like this one, bank the earth back so that when you do water it, the water sits at the top of the bank and soaks in rather than again running straight away. Place your pots into plastic trays so that any water that does drain through the soil can be captured underneath and either reused or recycled. This is an empty wine bottle from the weekend. I've rinsed it out, filled it with water, and I've plugged the top with soil. I'm now going to invert it and press it deep into the soil in the middle of these plants. The benefit of that is that it will act as a slow release watering system. The water from that bottle will be released over the course of the next 24 hours. I can see when more water is needed, and the bottle gets the water down deep to the roots of the plants where it's needed most. If you water onto the surface, there's quite a high chance that that water will just evaporate into thin air and do no good to the plants whatsoever. Place it out of the sun so that the water doesn't heat up, and be careful when using glass in your garden. Remove weeds. Not only are these weeds sharing the water with your plants, they're also stealing the plants' nutrients. Practice chop and drop. Once you've pulled them up, drop them on the soil near the plant, and the nutrients that that has stolen will eventually decompose and leach back into the soil. Always plan ahead. These colocasia are moisture loving plants. They love to have their feet in wet ground. So before I planted them, I dug all the soil out and I lined the hole with old compost bags so that the water sits in the soil rather than draining away. I also dug a lot of organic matter into the soil, which helps to retain the moisture, and I've planted them in the shade. You can save and preserve water by planning ahead with your plant choices and choosing the right plant for the right place. For example, these ferns and hostas enjoy damp, shady conditions, so I've planted them here at the rear of the cottage where they're nearly always in the shade. Conversely, if you've got a dry, sunny, exposed plot, choose Mediterranean type plants which are tolerant of drought conditions. That way you can save water because you won't have to water the plants quite so often. Also, know your plants and their individual water requirements. Some plants need far less water than others. I've shown you my fern garden. Those plants like to be moist and wet all of the time. This is my scented Mediterranean style border with lavenders, rosemaries, thymes and olives. Also, it's covered in weed fabric and a gravel mulch, so I can get away without watering this for a whole week, even at the hottest times of the year, and these plants will not suffer. Know your plants. Put away your hose pipe and employ a watering can. There is a reason why these get banned at the first sign of a water shortage, and that is because they are wasteful and indiscriminate. With a watering can, you can be much more discerning with your water use and get it right at the base of the plant where it's needed most. The hose pipe can be indiscriminate and spread the water far and wide all over the surface where it will just evaporate. And the next point is to apply a mulch. Now, a mulch does not have to be complicated. As you can see here on my veg plot, anything which goes over the soil surface will help. This old cardboard has the effect of stopping evaporation, and it will suppress weeds. And as I've already said, those weeds are sharing the valuable water that your plants need. So apply a mulch. It could be cardboard, it could be weed fabric and gravel, or it could be old garden waste. Anything that you can spread across the soil to stop evaporation. Next on the list is do some pruning. It stands to reason that if a plant emits moisture from its leaves, which it does because it sweats water as we do through our skin, if you remove half of the foliage from a plant, it will only need half as much water. We do this often when we plant new plants in the ground. We remove excess foliage. That will also help the roots establish more and get deeper into the ground where it can find extra water sources. Now, I'm not saying prune all your plants bare, but a little bit of judicious pruning will help save water in the garden. One of those plastic milk bottles cut in half with the lid on and a couple of holes carefully pierced into the lid, half full of soil for stability. Place it in the middle of a raised bed and then add water. Portion control. I know exactly how much I'm giving this bed, and I can see when that dries out that it might need more. Another simple way of drip feeding your plants with water. And portion control is a point worth mentioning twice, because that which can be measured can be managed. So by measuring the portions of water, I can manage my water usage and I avoid the risk of overwatering my plants with excess water. And of course, harvest and store water whenever it's possible to do so. And it doesn't have to be an expensive water butt from a garden center. These two simple plastic containers, an old plastic barrel and an old dustbin, gather enough water in a rainy spell to keep my vegetable garden going for a whole fortnight. I just have to occasionally plunge into it. Now, I've just talked about the idea of portion control as a way of delivering exactly the right amount of water to each plant, because enough is as good as a feast. We don't need to overwater plants. That's just wasteful. But how about being really brave and taking it a step further and having a period of time where we just don't water plants at all? And the reason I suggest that is not because I want to get into water shaming, but because it seems to me that at the first sign of any warm weather, we all seem to rush out into the garden and start watering our plants quite liberally. And it might not be necessary. For example, Look at these buddleias. I've never watered these once, and just look at how well they are doing. They've got deep roots. Any water I apply at the surface might not even be getting to their roots. It might just be a complete waste of time and energy. So perhaps consider watering every other day, or rotating the water around the garden from one bed to the next on consecutive days. Try it. The plants will let you know if they're in distress. So there you go. I've shared with you my ideas on how to save and preserve water in the garden, and also some thoughts on the effective application of water in the garden. What are your thoughts? Wherever you are in the world, what do you do to manage watering your garden? Please share your thoughts in the comments box below this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please do subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so. And don't forget to hit the like button, because it makes YouTube's algorithm understand that it's a video of value. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you soon.